Hello everyone, this is Sam, and today we will discuss the meaning of the movie The Matrix and talk about how it is connected with the philosophy of postmodernism, in particular with Jean Baudrillard. The Matrix trilogy is a cult phenomenon. The first part was released in 1999 and immediately gained a lot of fans. The film shows the world of the future. Intelligent machines have taken over the Earth and created a unified system for using the energy of the human body to develop their own civilization. They constructed the Matrix for the enslaved people. It's a virtual space in which human consciousness exists without realizing it's not the real world. In reality, there's a squad of rebels fighting the machines and waiting for the one, a hero who can defeat the machines and free humanity. The main character of the film is Neo, the One. One day, he meets very weird people who claim that the whole world is an illusion, a simulation. He was offered two pills, one to forget everything and move on, and the other one to find out the truth. Neo takes the second pill and begins to wake up. The film is about his journey, from timid attempts at training to merging with the reality of machines and the final battle was agent. The movie features technophobia, very characteristic of the late 90s. At that time, it was believed that progress was out of control and posed the gravest threat to humanity, and also that the machines that we created would soon enslave us. Another theme of the film is the concept of hyperreality, in which human consciousness resides. One of the concepts that inspired this line may be that of the origin of the universe. And according to this belief, the whole world is a computer simulation. But this hypothesis wasn't. Another concept that probably inspired the movie makers is the philosophy of Jean Baudrillard. The French philosopher and postmodern theorist wrote the book Simulacra and Simulation, where he used the Latin word simulacrum to identify important modern cultural features. By the way, we see this book at the beginning of the film, and the philosopher was even offered to play the architect's role, but he refused. Let's take a closer look at the concept of the simulacrum. The Latin word simulacrum, or likeness, shows that modern culture has reached the point where our images and signs no longer refer to reality. The concept of simulacrum appears. It's like we invented the word cat, but there was no such animal in reality. Baudrillard says that culture has become a set of simulacra, referring only to other simulacra but not to reality. The internet plays an essential role here. It's a digital reality that has no real analogs. Therefore, the philosopher calls the modern digital age the era of hyperreality. The basis of hyperreality is a simulation. Do you remember how in The Matrix, humanity was immersed in a simulation that didn't exist in reality? And that's exactly what we're talking about. Where can we find this phenomenon in our lives? The most vivid example is the media. When we receive news, we have no way to check whether what they want to show us really exists. Baudrillard criticizes the power of the media, which can show any phenomenon in the light they need. We lose trust in what we see. Another striking example is Instagram, which has developed its own visual language. We can find images of non-existent people and unreal life there. The images on Instagram do not seek to show what reality really looks like, but instead create their own reality, which we would want to imitate. Thus, the non-existent reality of Instagram subordinates and replaces the real world. The third example is advertising. How does it sell? It forms the desired image, which initially doesn't exist anywhere except in advertising. In The Matrix, we see a literal illustration of Baudrillard's ideas executed in the spirit of a technological dystopia. Baudrillard, by the way, didn't like the film at all because his idea was taken too literally and the concept of hyperreality took the form of a matrix. So, hyperreality was made real, whereas Baudrillard's hyperreal space is devoid of any contact with reality. The simulacrum that Baudrillard writes about doesn't hide reality from us, but completely replaces it. It is impossible to get out of hyperreality, as the characters in the film do, because it is all around us. In The Matrix, there is another rather psychological conflict that can be summed up as the bitter truth or the sweet lie. How much do we really want to live in reality? Do you remember Cypher, who betrays Neo's team? He chose to be in the illusory world of hyperreality, knowing that everything that he does is only an illusion of his consciousness, but a pleasurable one. And this is a classic conflict between reality and the image of reality, where the choice is actually not so simple. So Cypher may have a point. The Matrix is very difficult to interpret unambiguously. Wachowskis created a movie filled with symbols and allusions. For example, the names that they chose. Morpheus's dream in ancient Greek. Trinity refers to the Christian Trinity, and the ship Nebuchadnezzar is named after the Babylonian king who conquered Judea. But in many ways, these are symbols for the sake of symbols that are more likely to confuse than actually give a deeper understanding of the film. The main conflict of The Matrix is the confrontation between reality and the virtual world. So far, we still have the hope that there is a reality behind the virtuality. But the philosophy of postmodernism tells us that everything we see is already an image of an image, a simulacrum, and there is no reality behind it. So which pill would you choose?